Josh and Jared here with Wolf's Hollow Survival. You joined me the other day walking back to the river. It was raining outside. It wasn't the best day to go and shoot, but it was a day I really needed to get out in the woods. You guys ever have those days? I know Jared does. Don't you, Jared?
Absolutely. That's almost every day.
Almost every day. So, it was raining outside and I just wanted to go for a little hike back to the river. You've been with us at Wolf's Hollow. And we've been there for, what, 3 years?
Yeah. Well, 3 and a half now.
Yeah. 3 and a half years at Wolf's Hollow. And we've decided that we want to get a new spot. So we're hiking. Oh, man. Sorry. I burp when I chew gum. I don't know. Crazy. But thanks for joining us, guys. And we'll do a little bit of cool angles so it's really dramatic. I just got a new wide angle lens for my camera, so I'm super excited. It should help with filming our adventures. And it'll make it easier for you guys to see what we see if I don't slip and fall in the mud hole. Whoops. Oh well. That sucks. I just fell in all that. Not really. I stuck my foot in it. I've got holes in my boots. I mean, if you want to.
I'm not walking backwards. You're high.
All right, well, then go. I got it.
All right.
Oh, come on. I got a hole in my muck boot. And our trail is covered in ice. Well,
it's, frozen under the water.
Well, I hope stuff's frozen underneath me. Man. Is great. See, you're nice and light. I'm heavy and awkward, and I smash through this stuff.
Ooh. I scared you? Or you fell?
No, I fell. I fell too.
See, what I'm waiting for is a nice, wow, or a nice thin spot to bust through, and the next part will be thin, so my foot will hook through, you know, and I'll just feed it.
I really can't walk through there. Snuck by. Wow.
those two trees there.
That's awesome. There's geese on the river.
Coming?
Yeah. You have problems there, Joshua?
Yeah, well, just a little bit. I've got holes in my muck boots. I'm wearing them too much.
So what's the problem?
Well, I'm getting water inside. I'm too fat. Hey.
That's cheating. Minus 50 points.
Minus 50 points? I don't care. I'm still going to finish the race.
Okay, I'm going to fall in right here anyways. Well, maybe not. Okay, so here's the deal. We did a little bit of scouting closer to the river, and there was just nothing good. We did find one spot, but it was too close to our trail. I know in some cases you want to be able to be close to a trail, which is nice. But in our case, we want to be off the trail. We don't want to draw a bunch of attention. Just because we want to come out here and not have a bunch of people all around going, "Oh, you're camping!" Which is fine if there's one or two, but... So, we're going to go and find a new spot. We're going to go to the Hollow, and there's another reasonable spot, we think, close by. So we'll see you there. Okay. I think we done found our spot. It's nice and open to a point, but it's not too open. There's still a lot of overhead cover. But we're out of all that stupid water, and it looks to be like a nice ridge. What do you think?
It's good. It's good.
It's all good. All right. Well, let's start building.
You see that?
Yeah.
Or it'll just open right there.
All that water is down there. We're on top of the other side is where we were scouting first, and then it was just too mucky back there, so we wanted to come over here, and this is by far the better choice. We're up on a nice ridge.
Okay, so we found our spot. It's really nice. We're gonna do a raised platform between this tree, tree over here, tree back there, and then another hardwood over here. Right now we're cutting planks to support our floor. Should be a good time. These woods are filled with a bunch of dead ash because of the ash borer. So we're taking them out and we're going to use them. They're really good hardwood. They'll make for good building material, that's for sure.
Do you have more over there?
I chopped down this one.
Because there's that. You want to help me?
I don't think we'll get another piece out of that. I think it'll be 2 weeks, but you don't care.
No.
Up there close by that tree? Ba-ding!
Is that going to reach?
Across there, it should.
Until my ear.
We're going to be great. There you grab a drink. Is that enough over here?
Should we get the first up in the front done?
What do you mean?
Decide which, how high this needs to go.
Well, I'm going to have you tie it, because you've always been good at tying it good and tight in the right way. So if I hold it, we compromise and go to the middle.
But see how low that is over there? It's going to be up higher so that it's level with this.
Yeah, that's fine. What do you mean? So, like, press it. Yeah, that's fine. But you're up on the roots.
Yeah, because I'm up. So, right there. Which is going to be a lot higher up there.
Oh, no. Well, that's not where you were now, goddammit. We're using knee measurements here.
Knee measurements.
Wow. Okay. You're good on this one. You got, well, 8 inches.
That's what she said. I think that's good right there.
Yeah. Is that level? I need to go down in front.
Hey, we are at our mark.
It's right in the middle.
So we found our new camp location. It was on the other side of all that water. We pulled out of there and we went around to that ridge and we ended up finding a really awesome location. Really awesome. There's hemlock trees. There's ash trees in there that we're able to cut down and utilize for building materials because they're all dead. Because of the ash borer, and it really sucks, but what can you do? It's good building material. So what you guys saw is us building that frame for our floor. It's a raised floor. It's about knee height on me. We put that up and we got it all tied up with a paracord, and it started to get dark, so we wanted to work as opposed to filming a lot because we got out there really late. Then after we were done with that, we started getting an area cleared out for a fire, and we built a fire and we cooked some dinner on it, and we were just kind of chatting about, oh, we could do this or oh, we could do that. And we ended up pulling out of there probably around like 9:30 at night. So it was really a lot of fun. And next time I promise that you guys will see more of us building that and the surrounding location and why it's so cool. Because it's just cool. There's so many different trees. There's spruce, hemlock, there's popple in there, there's ash trees, there's maple, there's oak, all sorts of kinds of trees in there. So it's a really awesome variety, and it's great. So we will see you next time. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for putting up with my semi-little stutter, because I jumble words every now and then, but I'm really looking forward to bringing you guys some awesome videos of us being out in the woods, showing you guys what you can do, what we do when we're out there to survive. If we really needed to, we could stay out there. We could. Excuse me. I burp a lot when I drink orange juice for whatever reason. But keep tuning in for video updates and check us out on Facebook. It's Wolf's Hollow Survival on Facebook. And our YouTube's the same thing, Wolf's Hollow Survival. And we should be developing a website here pretty soon. I'm still waiting on internet for my computer at home so I can start video editing here at home. Right now, I edit somewhere else. And I'd really like to bring it all right here because then I could put a lot of time into it. But thanks for tuning in. We'll see you next time. Thank you.